Sunday times if there's hot chicks in the supermarket.
Hey, Artie, here's this is great. This is Artie's mom. This is why Artie will never get married.
All right.
Here's Artie's mom on his voicemail.
Art, hi, it's Mom. It's Saturday night. Okay, Stacey brought the food home. You got a bunch of container of meatballs in the freezer and a container in the refrigerator, and there's mushrooms and some sautéed spinach and some hot peppers that you left there, okay? And if you have any food that I bought you last week, please throw it out. Bye.
Please throw it out.
So, wait a minute. Your mom prepares food, and then somebody brings it and puts it in your
refrigerator. Robin, let me...
Two enablers. Well,
by the way, when she says a Tupperware, she's got a vat of meatballs.
Okay, a vat. I'm going to say in each container of meatballs, there's 20 meatballs.
Right.
So she left me 40 meatballs.
Wow.
That she cooked.
And boy, that's great. Oh, boy, my mom doesn't do anything for me.
Let me tell you something.
Your mom's a slacker.
Picture working all week. I go up to a gig in Albany, okay?
Right.
Drive home, do like a signing, do a gig, drive back, get back Sunday, hungover, and there waiting is just a buffet of meatballs and hot peppers and sauteed spinach.
That would be the end of me. You know why? Because I'd eat everything in that vat.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Yeah.
You just sit there with a bowl of meatballs on your belly.
You know what I do? She gets those fried hot peppers, and I take them, and I break them with the oil, and I put them in the meatball and make a little meatball hot pepper sandwich.
Wow.
And then just dunk the bread in all the hot pepper oil.
You know what I do?
Seeds.
I learned this from Beth. I keep the refrigerator empty.
Yeah.
That right. And every time you go to look in it, there's nothing.
I go, oh, I'm going to get something to eat. And I look in it, and I go, there's nothing here I can eat.
Right. Oh, there's nothing here.
And then I go back to being hungry.
She leaves me great bread, too. Like, you know, you just sap everything up.
Where does she get the bread?
Sometimes she goes to this bakery, Calandra's, which is out of Newark.
Nice.
Sometimes she goes to this place, Vidiello's in Nutley.
Like, she, like, actually goes to special places.
Yeah.
Like,
she
doesn't go to bakery. She's not going to the supermarket. Yeah.
Oh, at holidays, there's a big discussion about where we're getting the bread.
Yeah.
You know, some people have different...
My mom was like that. My mom was like that, but she doesn't do it anymore. Like, she used to go, like...
She's old.
My mother would be like, I'm going shopping. I only do one thing a day. I'm going to the special fruit place. So she'd have a special fruit place, and I'm going to the special vegetable place. And then she'd go... I'm going to go to the butcher. You know what I mean? Like, because she had a special butcher.
Once a day. I mean, like, she couldn't do them all in one day.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Fish and meat have to be fresh.
Mom, I like that.
You know, and I was like, wow. And you know what? I used to eat from a can. I'd eat Chef Boyardee because I was my way of pissing on her. You know what I mean? It was just like, you know, hey,
yeah,
F
who,
you.
Who cares about your fresh food?
Who cares about your fresh food? You know what? Open up a can of Chef Boyardee. I'd sit there and eat Chef Boyardee and meatballs out of a can while she made delicious fresh food. I didn't appreciate it. And
but
then,
she never was stocking your refrigerator when you grew up.
We never got into that.
No, but not, I mean, even as kids, it wasn't a stocked fridge for you?
No. Always stocked.
Yeah, in the house. But she wasn't stocking another house.
I'm an adult now.
But, you know, I got a question.
I'm an adult. She leaves it up to me.
Yeah.
Artie. When I lived in L.A., the first birthday I spent in Los Angeles, a UPS guy comes with, like, a hand truck. 5 Sicilian pizzas in bubble wrap for my birthday.
Your mother made them?
No. She made 2 of them and bought 3 of them.
How do you mail a pizza?
She put it all in bubble wrap.
But doesn't it go bad after, like, a day or
two? She overnighted it.
You freeze it.
And I got it on my birthday.
Did she freeze it?
Yeah.
Wow.
I guess, and then the rest of like next 2 weeks, my apartment in L.A. was just covered in crumbs.
He's got a whole mother thing going.
Well,
on.
That's my question.
You told
absolutely
me the other day.
Wait, what?
Does everybody in Artie's family have a key to Artie's place?
I don't know how it works.
My mother insisted, though.
Yeah, well, that's everyone in your family.
My sister lives right up the block. Me and my sister are very close, so we have keys to each other's places.
But do you have rules about when to use
your
key?
Sister has a key to your place?
Yeah, but
and then she like walks in and like
she doesn't come unannounced.
I'm telling you, there's a whole weird Artie mom and sister thing.
She doesn't you come said unannounced. That the mom had made the food and the sister delivered it. It sounded like Artie wasn't home. It just appears in the refrigerator.
And I'm guessing. Go ahead. Yeah.
And then you said to me a week ago that Artie stops by his mom's on a regular basis, like at work and stuff.
Well, I'm guessing.
Well, not
the girlfriend, Dana, takes like third place to the
absolutely
mom and the sister.
And that the mom and the sister probably don't like Dana because she could take them. She could take Artie away.
She could knock him out.
Oh, that's absolutely.
That's not true.
Guarantee it.
It's not.
I'll bet any amount of money. Your sister gets along with Dana?
Yeah, they do.
I don't buy it.
You know what I think it is?
I don't think it is. I don't buy it at all.
We all have a great time.
You know what I think it is? Keeping your enemies close.
Yeah, but I'm telling you.
Pretending to like a mob thing? Piss you off.
There's a thing going on there.
Yeah.
Artie loves it.
There's a thing going on because my mother made me some meatballs?
Nah, with the keys. Who would give their sister and their mother a key to their apartment? I wouldn't.
Really?
I wouldn't. No way. You want your mother in there?
I'm close. She doesn't ever come just stop by.
Do you want some boundaries?
But wait a second. Do you ever think that, Artie, seriously, maybe I grew up in a different family because I know my mother would do this, but you don't think that your mother comes by and, like, looks through your stuff?
Never. Gar, I'm telling you, man, she just does not.
Oh, you're dreaming.
Well, what does she have to look through? She's doing his bills.
You're right.
It's true. She's seeing everything.
My mother would look at everything. She would look at letters.
Gar, you know what? That's just not the case.
My mother would, too. My mother would go in my room and inspect.
Exactly.
And invade every bit of my privacy.
Just doesn't believe it's happening. It's happening.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not happening. I'll put a hidden camera in there.
A mom cam.
You don't want to see what's on that hidden camera.
They go in there, they leave the meatballs and the hot peppers, and they leave.
They look things over.
There's nothing to look over.
They're knowing everything about you, Artie.
Don't stop it.
They're so involved with him.
And you know what, Artie? The reason you don't give your mom or your sister your keys is because you left home.
I know.
You might as well be at home.
Well, you know who he reminds me of? You ever see that movie with Ernest Borgnine?
Marty? Yes.
He's Artie.
Artie is Marty.
Yeah. I never saw Marty.
Watch the movie Marty.
He's a butcher who lives with his mom in the Bronx.
Okay, yeah, an exact parallel.
Well,
I'm a butcher who lives with my mom.
Well, but he's got a close relationship with his mom.
Okay, so kill me. I got a close relationship with my mother. What do you want me to tell you?
I was thinking about that the other day. I said, Artie's a mama's boy.
Artie's the
husband. That I'll admit to. I'm a Gindaloon mama's boy.
Artie's the husband substitute.
But, hey, Artie, does Dana cook for you?
There's some things I just won't do.
No, Dana never cook for you?
No need.
Of course she does.
And how does...
Dana makes a wicked breakfast, by the way.
I just always wonder...
What does she make?
Mozzarella omelet.
Oh, really?
Yeah, mozzarella omelet with, sometimes potatoes and eggs, pepper.
But what kind of mozzarella does she use? Paleo or homemade?
We go get the mozzarella at Bianca Manos in Hoboken.
Oh, my goodness.
See?
Oh, my goodness. What's the matter? I can't shop at a deli for mozzarella?
No, but the point is Dana only has one meal left. She can only make breakfast.
Come on.
No room for dinner.
11 o'clock snack she can do.
I try to take my darling out for a nice dinner.
Dana, we don't need bread. My mom already picked up special bread. Delicious bread.
Does Dana ever go, I don't feel like meatballs tonight, I feel like Chinese food?
We go out to eat!
Oh, trust me, he ain't sharing his meatballs with Dana. Guarantee it.
Actually, no, I just eat my
meatballs. Yeah, I know. You're sitting there sloshing them down by yourself.
So it's known
I sit there with my meatballs and watch the Devil Race beat the Yankees.
That's why you can't even live with Dana.
Right.
He doesn't want that interrupted.
What, is mom going to stock their apartment?
Artie.
No. Yeah.
Who's a better cook, Dana or your mommy?
My mother.
Of course.
That's just a fact.
But if you were married, right?
Like saying who runs faster, me or, Michael Jordan.
If you were to get married.
Your mom's the Michael Jordan of cooking?
Actually, she is, Ryan.
If you were to get married, right, just hypothetically.
Which is a very big possibility.
Okay, would it seem, would the...
Artie's got a good move with that. He goes, absolutely big possibility.
Definitely maybe.
Yeah, he's smarter than I am. He is.
I met a girl who I love to death.
I'm an ass. I go like... I'm never getting married. That bums a woman out. You just go, yes, one day I can see that happening.
Possibility.
Some point in the future.
One day I see that scenario somewhat playing out.
Yes.
You act as if you're 22. At this point, you should know.
All right. So you and Dana.
I know.
Get married, say.
Colleen brought on.
Do you think that the drop-offs from mom should stop if you guys were married?
Yes. I do think that would be an intrusion.
And what if your mom didn't want to stop?
Because then it becomes Dana's household. Like, she's the woman of the house.
Right.
Then that would be an intrusion on her
house. What if your mom said, Artie, I've been doing this for years. I want to continue to do it.
She will not. She'll respect it. I'm telling you, you got to be. My mother is not like she's a modern. Robin met my mother. She's
and
a very
she doesn't
modern,
look like the kind of woman who would be doing this.
No, she's a good cook, so I take advantage of it. I live 10 miles from her. In L.A., I had to go eat the crappy L.A. food. I lived out there for years.
No wonder you bummed out in L.A. I think it was the food issue.
And mommy.
Let me tell you something. Food was a big deal for me.
You couldn't be away from your mom.
I don't like being away from home at all.
Right.
My buddies and, you know, yeah. I love New
he
York.
He is Marty. And... Remember Marty had the whole bunch of guy right. friends?
I'm just like the butcher from the Bronx.
Artie, what do you want to do tonight? I don't know. What do you want to do? I don't know.
Sounds like a great time.
We got to take a break.
Shoot a little pool.
All right. Hey, listen. You got a good setup. Don't change anything, believe me. Don't get pressured. He's got a great setup.
Where would I get pressured? Home, right. work, where?
Sophie's Choice. Ready? I was explaining to my daughter Sophie's Choice. She was asking me which one of my daughters I love the most.
Right.
And
that must have been a fun conversation.
And I told her about Sophie's. All right. Dana and your mom, the Nazis come to Jersey. All right. They say to you, Artie, we're going to have some fun today. You're a big fat Italian.
Right.
We're going to have fun with you.
Right.
All right. Here's your beautiful girlfriend, Dana.
I'm with you so far.
And here's your beautiful mother, Galuli, or whatever her name is.
Judy. Judith Ann.
Which one do you want to be taken away to the death camp, and which one do you want to live? And you can't say, I can't answer, because then we'll kill both of them. Who do you keep alive?
My answer is... Give my mother a half an hour to teach Dana how to make meatballs and take her away.
All right, so you'd kill your mother and you'd let Dana live.
No, I'd just say take her to the camp. I wouldn't say kill her.
Right. Whatever happens to her, let her survive. Hopefully she'll survive.
Let her go to the... I'm sure at the camp she'd start making hot peppers for the soldiers.
Right.
I think it would be great. She'd be fine.
In other words, your mom's a better survivor than Dana and she'll handle it.
So you keep Dana.
Right.
Yeah.
Wow.
Whatever you want, however you want to twist it.
No, I'm not twisting it.
I don't think he's doing this real world. He's not telling us the truth.
You can't make love to
your mom. I'm not treating the Nazis come to Jersey scenario real.
I'm saying.
Sorry.
I'm saying Artie's killing Dana.
Oh, absolutely.
I am not. I'm telling you, my mother would go to that death camp. There's not an SS guy who would resist her meatball. She'd be fine.
All right. Artie's mom goes to the death camp. He made his decision.
She goes to camp.
All right, Artie. We take her now. Come on, Judy.
Oh, Faith. Taste this broccoli rub.
Please bring me back my mommy.
Taste this broccoli rub.
Artie, please. You're your mama. I'm your mama.
Why you do these to me?
Nothing about this is real.
You could always find another girl to bang you.
Hey, can I ask Artie one more question?
Yeah. Go ahead, Gary.
How does your laundry get done?
I got a Mexican bro that comes in.
Oh, okay. Oh.
Your mom hire her?
I hire her. I make money.
Did your mom find her?
Actually, a buddy of mine recommended.
All right.
Said you don't steal nothing.
Dominic, you're on the air.
How many times a week does his mother come now? She's only bringing the food once.
Oh, I imagine.
And the maid is only coming once a week, so who makes the bed, picks the clothes up?
I don't ever make my bed during the week.
Who does it, your mom?
The cleaning woman comes in on a Tuesday.
The Mexican comes a couple of days a week?
Once a week,
so, does all the laundry, changes the sheets, makes the bed, and then I never make the bed again. Right now, my bed isn't made.
Your mom never comes over and straightens it up?
No!
Absolutely
not! 1,000% no! You think my mother still works? You think she gets up to make
I
my
heard your
bed?
Mom decorated your whole apartment in her taste.
Well, she used a decorator, and she's very talented at decorating.
She'd made all the selections.
She sounds like the perfect woman.
Wouldn't you want to, like, maybe... Decorate it on your own?
She chose everything except the Belushi picture above my bed.
Right.
That I didn't fight her on.
Did you hear who Artie says is very talented? Not the decorator. His mother.
Right.
The decorator. Her and some gay guy did it. I don't know. I just said, don't make it look fruity.
But Artie, how does she get your bills?
Well, not all. She doesn't do all my bills.
Don't make it look fruity.
That's the only thing I said to the two.
That worked.
Guys, I'm going to leave.
I know. You can get a gay decorator before you know it. They're painting every room different weird colors.
Oh, yeah. I have flowers. Everything's a pattern of plant and
I had to make some edits. I said, guys, I'm not in NSYNC.
Right.
I know. Who does the dishes?
I'm a butcher.
Yeah, who does the dishes every day? How often did your mother come over and do the dishes?
She doesn't. The Mexican brother.
Once a week.
Once
you can't keep
week.
Your dishes around for a week.
I use paper plates. I'm a bachelor. I eat out a lot.
Right.
I don't have a lot of dishes done.
I don't buy it.
You don't put them in the dishwasher? You can't do
that? What I do is I wash them off and put them in the dishwasher, and then the cleaning woman takes care of them.
Artie, she takes the... When she brings the meatballs over there...
Dominic, please.
She takes the pan back to her house, washes it, puts new meatballs in.
That's right.
No, they're disposable pans.
Yeah.
I can throw them out.
Let's see. She does the bills.
She does a couple of bills.
All right.
Come on.
Why is she only doing a couple of bills?
I pay her. She's on a payroll. She's part of the corporation.
Of course she's on the payroll.
Other than sex, she's your wife.
Right.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
I don't live with her.
I don't live with my wife, too.
How often do you guys talk?
In fact, all his wives he doesn't live with.
How often do you guys talk? Every day?
A few times.
Every other day, maybe.
Every single day.
That's not true. That's not
two
true.
To three times a day.
Well, all right, so I'm willing to make a bet against your cell phone record. Three to four, maybe 5-1 odds. You speak to your mother 2-3 times a day.
I don't use a cell phone. I'm a former longshoreman. I don't talk on cell phone.
Well.
That's gay.
I do all my business by, you know, no paper. No.
A cell phone is gay.
Yes.
A cell phone's fruit.
You don't do that, do you?
And I barely use it.
I have a friend. He's an Italian guy, too, like kind of old school like you. He won't use a cell phone either.
He's
in denial because his wife has a cell phone, and basically everyone reaches him through that.
It reminds me, when I first moved to L.A., my agent had this fruity assistant who always had a cell phone, and that's what I see. Yeah.
You know that if you call Artie on a cell phone, you can't leave him a message. You can, but he tells you right up front, don't bother leaving a message because I don't retrieve them.
You know
who else is like that? Adam Carolla.
Yeah.
Carolla. He goes, call me back, but not on my cell. I don't know how to answer it.
Well, but really? Artie's thing is, if you don't get him on the cell phone, then you don't get him.
Yeah. If I happen to have my cell phone on and rings, I answer it. Unless I see the number and it's someone I want to talk to.
No, but Dominic hit it on the head. In other words, the mother has become the wife for all purposes except sex.
And Artie's become the husband.
Right, and Dana becomes the sexual outlet.
Right.
But she can't worm her way into his life because he's got every other portal closed up.
That's why she doesn't live with him. Everything's covered at Artie's. He's got it down.
That's not true.
Unless she presses the issue, it's not going anywhere.
One last question.
Yeah, Dominic.
Not to raise a tough subject, but
you wouldn't want to raise a tough subject.
If there was a movie, is your mother doing the catering?
She'll be doing my catering.
Right. All right, Dominic, thank you for the intrusive phone call.
I'll be taking a bag lunch.
Mozzarella, mozzarella, mozzarella balls. I eat them like Tic Tacs and swallow them all. Brajolich got all with buffalo wings. Jack Daniels and Vicodins.
Mozzarella, mozzarella for my hearty. With fresh money got and calamari. Super depressed and broccoli rock. Teens like a slob.
Strumpalash, Fiadelle, and some fresh biscotti. Raviolis and cannolis. I eat them up like a Mensa funnel. Serve it up, cause I love to eat. And I'll drink until I fall.
I know if I write a musical starring all of us with our families,
yes. It'd
be a huge hit in Broadway. I know it.
I would pay to watch them do that together.
Right.
Hey, every night.
Unbelievable.
Well, I'm sitting here thinking of Artie and his mom. He really is attached.
And hey, Gary loves my mother, by the way. Admit it, Gary.
Hey, I absolutely love your mother.
What's the thing before Broccoli Rob? What's the food there that you mentioned in the song?
I don't know. Sal wrote that, actually.
Oh, did he?
I don't know. Maybe he knows.
He probably knows. No.
Brajol.
No, what's the cookie?
Biscuit?
Yeah.
No, that's not before Broccoli Rob.
Broccoli?
Yeah, I tried to leave.
Mozzarella, mozzarella, mozzarella balls. I eat them like Tic Tacs and swallow them.
All right, I won't go through the whole thing. All right, we got to take a break. We'll be back right after these words.
The Howard Stern Show.
Hi, good everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien. Welcome to The Insider. Let's get right to the big story everybody's talking about.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for inviting me into your presence once more.
Howard Stern.
It's good to be with you.
The Howard Stern Show.
Molly lives at home with her father, her mother, and her older sister, Jeannie. Jeannie and Molly each have their own rooms, but lately it seems that Molly is more interested in Jeannie's room than her own. Molly and Jeannie get along, well, about as most sisters do.
Molly, what do you think you're doing? How many times have I asked you to leave my things alone?
Jeannie, when do you think I'll start having periods, too?
Oh, I don't know. Pretty soon, I suppose. I was 13 when I started.
Well, Peggy's already started hers, and I'm 6 months older than she is.
Well, so what? Some start earlier, some later. We're all different. Shouldn't be long now.
Period music.
One day, not long after that, Molly came home from school.
That you, Molly?
Mom, guess what?
What?
Mom, I started my first period.
Well, what do you know?
Come on, sit down.
Tell me about it. When did it start?
Well, it was this afternoon when I was changing into my gym clothes, and I noticed a bit of blood on my panties, and golly, at first I thought, well, I didn't know what to think. And then I remembered when we talked about
menstruation.
Menstruation and stuff, and, well, then I went to see Miss Jensen.
Oh, my goodness. How do you feel?
Kind of funny-like. I mean, well, I was hoping it would start soon, but it seems like I've forgotten everything you've told me.
What are you two up to?
Uh-oh.
What's all the talk about in here? Is this a private conference?
No, I don't think so.
You guys talking about girl crap?
You, Molly?
No, I guess not.
Molly's growing up. She's having her first menstrual period.
I'll see you.
What? Already? Oh, but Alice, I thought... Well, I mean, after all, she's only...
Dad, okay. Don't be so silly. I'm not a baby anymore.
Oh, great. Now you're going to be getting laid.
Yeah.
Look, Daddy doesn't want to talk about Mommy's period.
Hey, get off my lap, Molly.
Right.
You got a pad on or what?
No, dear, but no, honey, I guess you are.
Is it true that people can tell when you're menstruating?
No, it isn't.
I can smell you a mile away.
But you should be more careful than ever about personal cleanliness and dainties. Change your underwear more often, and be sure and use a deodorant. And pay more attention to your hair and your nails, and plan to wear your prettiest dress. In other words, be your most attractive self. And remember, menstruation is as normal and natural as eating, or breathing, or sleeping.
Thanks for taking the fun out of it. I'm going to the garage
soon,
and drink.
Molly will be a young woman like Jeannie, having dates, going to dances in lovely romantic dresses, and making new and important friends.
Right.
Growing up, it's an exciting time.
Leave it to Beaver.
Mom sounds like she hasn't seen a period in about 15 years.
Yeah, Mom sounds like she's in a, like on Vicodin or Xanax.
Can't wait for
Mom is sedated.
Can't wait for Dad to meet one of Molly's new important friends she makes.
You know Molly. I like when she goes, you know, Molly, that it's very important now to practice hygiene and
change your underwear.
Change your underwear more
often.
How often
was Molly changing her underwear before?
Every 4 days. Crust growing.
Yeah, might want to improve that batting average.
You want to cake some rouge on.
I like when Dad comes in.
Dad sounds like he's about to...
And of course, the daughter's not embarrassed. Oh, no, you can join in on my period discussion.
That's exactly
how
it happens.
Secret, Dad.
What are you talking about, Negroes? No, Dad, we're talking about the period. Oh, well, stay away from Negroes.
Yeah.
And watch, keep your eye on those Puerto Rican boys.
Make all your important friends white.
And change your underwear, Mom.
change your underwear once in a while.
It's a private conference, or can anybody get in on it?
Yeah, and shave an interesting design in your hairs.
Dad, I'm having my first period. Okay, I'll be reading the paper in the living room.
Yeah, and stay off the couch.
Slap on some perfume.
Stay off the couch. It's white. And I forgot to put the plastic on the couch.
Guys, it looks like someone was murdered on the couch. Molly, tell Dad why it looks like someone was murdered on the couch.
Yeah, like, right? I could never talk to my mom or my dad about anything personal. That's a little too... I don't know. Somehow things didn't work out that way. I always ended up yelling in my house. You know what I mean?
Well, I wonder how your sister found out about all this stuff.
Listen.
Who knows? My sister was pretty browbeaten, just like me. We were both shell-shocked.
My uncle was 11 years old. My other older uncle set him up on a date. He's 11. He set him up on a date with a chick who lived next door. So he goes out with her. They go to like a candy shop or something. He comes home. My older uncle goes, "You get laid?" he goes, "No, I didn't do anything." He goes,
"I'm 11.
And my other uncle goes, "Oh, what are you, a fag?"
Oh, my God.
You don't know how to move. When I was your age, I was sleeping with everything to walk.
At 11, he was sleeping with.
Yeah, right.
My uncle's 11. He's starting to cry. This is a fag.
They should make that training film.
Yeah, that's good. You get laid?
Hi, Uncle. Hi there, nephew. Yeah. I set you up on a date.
Right. You did?
Yes, I did. Did you get laid? That would be a great training film.
No. What are you, a fag?
Are you a fag? Here's what not to do.
Well, see, that's why I always thought those training films were dangerous. They're acting as if every parent is responsible. Everybody knows what to say.
See, I think the training film is for the parents.
Really? Yeah. But they're showing it in school.
I know. They're showing it to the wrong people. I'd love to have understanding parents like that.
My old man gave me a quick sex talk, real quick.
Yeah.
It was, you know, after work one day. He sat me down.
At least he gave it to you.
Yeah. You didn't have anything?
I was like 14 and my mother goes, she hides in the bathroom. Mm-hmm. My parents had a bedroom. No, I had to be older already. I had to be about 16.
Really?
Because we were living in Rockville Center, and my parents had a bathroom in their bedroom, which was unheard of.
Right, at that time.
Yeah. So my mother goes, "Your father wants to talk to you." And then I walk into the bedroom. He's laying in bed. I think he was naked under the bed.
Oh,
I don't know what.
No.
He's reading the New York Times, and he's in his boxer underwear and chest hairs. And he can't even look up from the paper. He can't stand me.
And your mom goes into the bathroom?
My mother goes and hides in the bathroom with the door cracked open. Like, I don't know she's in there. Like, where else would she be? She's listening. My father goes, and I was already messing around with chicks. You know,
well,
I was
16
pretty...
16 is old.
Yeah, it was a little too late for this. And I don't even know what prompted. Maybe my mom found some of my underpants that made her think...
You needed a talking to.
Yeah, or she saw my stag films and porno collection or whatever. And my father goes, do you have any questions about sex? And I just got... He didn't even look up from his paper. And I didn't look at him because we never look at each other when we talk. Right. And I just went, hey, I got really embarrassed. I know more than you.
Yeah.
You know, because the way I looked at it was the only one he's getting is my mother.
If that.
And he goes, okay. And that was it. That was my sex talk.
Oh, my goodness.
Then I went to this guy, Howard Carger, who taught me everything about sex. He let me smell his fingers.
A friend of yours.
My friend's older brother. He was a great guy. Always getting laid.
Guys with older brothers always knew a lot more about everything, drugs, sex.
He said, he came home one night, and he says, yeah, I got to third base with this chick. I go, yeah, can we smell your fingers? He was like, okay, I don't care. He was such a cool guy. And
yeah.
I was like, whoa.
Oh, you actually smell something?
Yeah, I think so. But I thought, I was like, wow, these fingers
like,
actually.
How would you know what you should smell?
I don't know, but it was just like, whoa. I think it was Molly from the training film. But he played bass in a band, and, you know, he had a rock band. He was a cool dude. Uh-huh. Like, he was getting girls. He was, like, you know, 19 or something.
My friend's older brother would let us smell his fingers after he had a nice prosciutto sandwich. No. Roasted peppers.
But, you know, so. And that was my intro into sex.
Yeah, nobody's talk is like any of these stupid films.
No.
No, well, like, that film is complete, you know.
Hey, kids, anyone want to smell my fingers?
I do.
Yeah, there should be an older boy in the film going, hey, get over here.
Yeah.
Pretty soon, Molly will be turned out for heroin.
That's right.
Boy, I got to tell you, I'm